Hi guys, how are you all? Every one of you, how are you? I hope you're fine, and I really hope you're preparing for your GATE BT 2021 with full dedication and enjoying the process of learning. Because you see, process of learning is always enjoyable only if you understand, right? If you understand, then it is simple. If it is simple, then it is enjoyable. We always find things which are simple more enjoyable than the complex thing. Complex thing we don't like, right? So the simple things are more enjoyable because we understood the things. So let's try to understand today enzyme kinetics and inhibition. I'm your educator Saranya, and in your YouTube channel Gurmantra Siksha Ka Granth. So what do you understand by the term kinetics? Kinetics is nothing but movement. There is movement. Okay, movement of anything. Kinetics means movement. So enzyme kinetics is the study of enzyme reaction rate. Here the enzyme reaction rate is moving, which means the enzyme reaction rate is increasing. Okay, enzyme reaction rate is increasing. That is what we are going to study in the enzyme kinetics. Rate is nothing but the speed. Enzyme increases the rate of the reaction by establishing stabilizing transition state by lowering the energy barrier. Okay, so what does an enzyme do? It increases the rate of a reaction. It increases the speed of the reaction. It will stabilize the transition state. How does it stabilize the transition state? By lowering the energy barrier. Okay. You see in this graph, this is a graph where energy versus reaction rate, reaction coordinate. This is the reactants you have, which means substrate. The red line will tell you without enzyme. The reaction is without enzyme. So you see the energy barrier is so high. So it requires activation energy, which is so high, in order to form product here. Activation energy of the enzyme. Activation energy of the enzyme, you see here, it is low. When you compare it with the reaction without enzyme. What this enzyme has done is it has reduced this energy barrier. It has reduced the energy barrier. This much energy barrier it has reduced, and this is the energy barrier now. With enzyme, you can easily come across this barrier and your product can be formed. So what does an enzyme do? It will reduce the energy barrier of the transition state. Okay, transition state means the substrate is transitioning into the product. That is the transition state, the intermediate state. Okay. Now we are going to see the Michaelis-Menten equation. Michaelis-Menten has given kinetic equation for enzyme catalyzed reaction. He has told about the kinetics for the enzyme catalyzed reaction. You see, enzyme catalyzed reaction and the reaction without any enzyme has some difference, right? The difference is that it requires lot of energy and the time taken is a lot for a reaction without the enzyme. So here you see a substrate is there and it is getting converted to product, and this takes a lot of energy and lot of time. But if the reaction is catalyzed with an enzyme, it is taking only less time, and the reaction speed is very high. So enzyme plus substrate will give you enzyme substrate complex. This substrate will react with the enzyme and it will give you product. When the product is formed, it will detach from the enzyme. That is enzyme plus product. Okay. Michaelis-Menten has given an assumption that the rate of formation of ES complex, that is enzyme substrate complex, is equal to the rate of dissociation into the product. So formation of ES is equal to the dissociation of enzyme and product. Okay, so enzyme plus substrate will give you enzyme substrate complex that will dissociate to enzyme and product, Here K1, K2 and K minus 1 are the rate constant. Like this is for forward reaction, this is for reverse reaction, that is the rate constant. And the Michaelis-Menten equation is this one. Very important equation, note it down because you will get numerical from this. V0 is equal to Vmax substrate concentration divided by Km plus substrate concentration. So this equation is very important. I'll explain you the equation, don't worry. V0 is the initial velocity with which the reaction is taking place. Vmax is the maximum velocity, that is the maximum velocity attained after which you cannot increase the velocity. Maximum, that is the maximum, okay, the saturated one. Km is the concentration of substrate at half Vmax. Km is inversely proportional to the affinity of the enzyme to the substrate. We'll understand this in detail, okay, don't worry at all. So this is the Michaelis-Menten graph, okay. This graph is between substrate concentration in the x-axis and reaction velocity V0 in the y-axis. Okay, you see here, this is a hyperbolic curve. Okay, here you see enzyme, you have substrate. So slowly the substrate, what it is doing, it is occupying the active site of an enzyme and the reaction is increasing. The reaction between the enzyme and the substrate to convert into product is increasing. Slowly it is increasing, you see, it is increasing. So what happens in this is, enzyme has active site. Always the enzyme concentration in any reaction will be less only. It will not be more. It will be less only. Substrate concentration will be more. Okay. So initially what will happen? The substrate will come and settle itself in the active site. Okay. It will occupy the active sites one by one. So as the substrate is occupying the active site of the enzyme one by one, the reaction rate, the reaction velocity is increasing slowly, okay. Then there will come a time when the substrate has occupied all the reaction sites, all the active site of the enzyme. Now, enzyme does not have any free active site at all. All the active site of the enzyme has been bound by the substrate. No more substrate can bind there. Then what happens? The reaction velocity will become saturated because the enzyme has become saturated with substrate. So that is what we call as Vmax. That is the maximum velocity that enzyme can reach because it is saturated with substrate. Even though you increase the concentration here, you see the x-axis is increasing concentration, right? Even though you increase the substrate concentration, the enzyme does not have any vacant space. The enzyme does not have vacant active site where the substrate can go and occupy itself. Right? Therefore, even though you increase the substrate concentration, the enzyme is already saturated. So the Vmax is not going to increase. Vmax will stabilize. The Vmax will saturate. Okay? So that is what this graph is telling you about. So Vmax is the maximum velocity which an enzyme can reach when it is saturated completely with all the substrates in its active site. Okay, half the Vmax you take, for example, this value is 60. So half the Vmax will be 30. Okay, you take this value here and you extend it to the x-axis and you will get a value called as Km. So what is Km? Km is the concentration of substrate. Where is Km present? It is in the substrate concentration. So Km is nothing but it is the concentration of substrate at half Vmax. Okay? And why is this important? Because Km will tell us the affinity about the substrate to the enzyme. So what will Km do? It will tell us the affinity of the substrate to the enzyme. Km is inversely proportional to the affinity. Remember that Km is inversely proportional to the affinity. If Km is large, then the affinity between the substrate and the enzyme is low. Okay, and if the Km is very less, then the affinity between the substrate and the enzyme is very high. So this is what you have to remember. You have to understand what is Vmax. You have to understand what is Km, because these two are very important in enzyme catalyzed reaction. Okay. So this is the Michaelis-Menten equation and plot. There is a disadvantage to this Michaelis-Menten equation and plot is that this plot is hyperbolic. Okay. It's a curve. After some times when Vmax has reached, this curve will meet the Vmax only at infinity, because after some time this curve and this Vmax will be parallel to each other. So we know parallel lines will meet only at infinity. So we will not get accurate value for Vmax. If we do not get accurate value for Vmax, we will not get accurate value for Km also, because half Vmax is what will give you Km, right? So in this plot, though this plot is very convincing, we can understand the basic concepts and all well, it is not giving us the accurate value for Vmax and Km, because this graph is a curve. So we will get good values, accurate values of Vmax and Km in a graph which is linear. Then comes a scientist, Lineweaver and Burke. Lineweaver Burke, he gave a plot, okay, he gave a plot which will linearize. He actually gave an equation. That equation will give you a plot which is a linear one. So Lineweaver-Burk plot is the most favored plot by the researchers, has two distinct advantages over the Michaelis-Menten plot. It gives the more accurate estimate of Vmax and more accurate information about the inhibition. Inhibition we will talk in a little while. For both these things, Vmax and inhibition, this gives an accurate value. Okay, that is what is important. We want accurate results. So this is the Lineweaver-Burk plot here. This is nothing but the inverse of the Michaelis-Menten plot. You see here, V0 is equal to Vmax substrate concentration by Km plus substrate concentration. If you inverse this, that is 1 by V0. If you inverse this, you will get the Lineweaver-Burk plot. So 1 by V0 is equal to Km by Vmax into 1 by substrate concentration plus 1 by Vmax. This is in the form of Y is equal to M. This is M. This is X. This is C. Okay. You plot the graph. Y is 1 by V0, X is 1 by S, then slope you will get as Km by Vmax, and intercept you will get as 1 by Vmax. Okay, so this is a plot to linearize the Michaelis-Menten equation, and mostly this plot is used by the researchers and scientists for their experiments and all, because this gives more accurate information. We always want accurate information. Similarly, Eddie Ostia also tried to linearize the Michaelis-Menten equation and plot. So his equation is V by S is equal to V by Km plus Vmax by Km. Okay. This is his equation and this is the plot. The plot, you see, it is between V0 and V0 by S. Okay. And the slope is minus Km, negative slope. That's why the graph, you see, it's coming negative. And Vmax by Km is the x-intercept. Vmax is the y-intercept. Okay. So this is also another plot to linearize the Michaelis-Menten plot. But the most frequently used one is Lineweaver-Burk plot. Haynes-Wolff also tried to linearize the Michaelis-Menten equation only. Here you see S by V is equal to 1 by Vmax into S plus Km by Vmax. Here X axis is S, Y axis is S by V, slope is 1 by Vmax, intercept is Km by Vmax. Okay, this is also in the form of Y is equal to Mx plus C. You can plot the graph. The Haynes-Wolff plot is another method that linearizes the Michaelis-Menten equation. In all these three plots, like Lineweaver-Burk plot, Haynes plot, Eddie Ostia plot, all these plot you can use for instead of Michaelis-Menten equation, so that you can get accurate values for Vmax and Km. But mostly we use line weaver bug plot because that is easy. Okay, if something is easy, we'll use that only, right? It'll give you accurate results and it is also easy. So next we are going to talk about is inhibitions. Enzyme inhibition, the term itself is telling you that something is inhibiting the enzyme, right? Something is inhibiting the enzyme, enzyme inhibitions. An enzyme inhibitor is a substance that disrupts the normal reaction pathway between enzyme and substrate. So what does this inhibitor do? This will not allow the product formation. Okay, it can be a reversible inhibitor or irreversible inhibitor. Reversible inhibitor means it will bind temporarily to the enzyme. If it is an irreversible inhibitor, it will bind permanently to the enzyme. So reversible inhibitors either bind to an active site, it is called as competitive inhibitor, or to another site of the enzyme, we call that as non-competitive inhibitors. So this graph you'll have to understand. This is a inhibition graph, okay, enzyme inhibition graph. On x-axis you have substrate concentration, on y-axis you have rate of a reaction. This is also like Michaelis-Menten only. So the normal enzyme without any inhibitor, you see, that is the violet line, it is going like this. It is following Michaelis-Menten, right? This is the Vmax and the half of the Vmax. On the x-axis you will get Km, like that. This is the competitive inhibitor. The green color one is the competitive inhibitor and the blue color one is the non-competitive inhibitor. See, the competitive inhibitor, what does it do is, it will compete. It will compete. The name says competitive. It will compete with the substrate of the, it will compete with the substrate to bind to the active site of the enzyme. Okay. Competitive inhibitor will compete with the substrate so that it can bind to the active site of the enzyme. Right. If it goes and binds to the active site of the enzyme, the substrate can no longer bind to the enzyme and the product formation will not take place. Always you see, enzyme concentration will be less. Similarly, inhibitor concentration will also be less. But the substrate concentration can be more. You can increase the substrate concentration always. So when you increase the substrate concentration and the inhibitor concentration is less, who wins the competition now? Because substrate is more in amount, it will easily beat the inhibitor and bind to the active site of the enzyme. Okay, and the reaction takes place. That's why when you increase the substrate concentration, you see in the graph, the substrate concentration as it is increasing, the competitive inhibitor graph will reach Vmax. That will be same as that of the normal enzyme. It will reach the Vmax same as that of the normal enzyme, but Km will be different because you see the graph is not same. It has somewhat varied. So this is Vmax. So half the Vmax, let's say this is half the Vmax. If you extend it here, this will be Km here. Km for normal enzyme without any inhibitor. If this is the half Vmax and for competitive inhibitor, you see the distance is increasing here, so the Km is also increasing. Km for normal enzyme is here and Km for competitive inhibitor is here, right? So Km is increasing but Vmax is same. We are going to see this only in detail, don't worry. So competitive inhibitors, they compete with the substrate to bind to the active site of the enzyme. It increases the Km, but the Vmax is unchanged because with enough substrate concentration, the reaction can still compete. I told you the same thing. So you see, this is a enzyme and inhibitor and substrate are competing with each other to bind to the enzyme because they are complementary. Right, the inhibitor is also complementary to the active site of the enzyme. So they will compete. So whichever binds first, it will take care of the enzyme. Like if inhibitor binds, it will inhibit the enzyme. If substrate binds, it will ask the enzyme to convert the substrate into product. Right? So our equation is V is equal to Vmax substrate concentration by Km into, this is about the inhibitor rate plus substrate. Here you see Vmax is same in this graph. You see this is the Lineweaver-Burk plot graph for the competitive inhibitions. I told you, right? Lineweaver-Burk plot gives you accurate values for inhibitions also. That's why for inhibitions we use Lineweaver-Burk plot. Vmax is same, Km is increasing, right? And how can you overcome this? You can overcome this by increasing the substrate concentration. The next we are going to see is uncompetitive inhibition. Uncompetitive inhibition is one where the inhibitor binds to the enzyme substrate complex. It does not bind to the enzyme. It binds to the enzyme substrate complex to stop the enzyme from reacting with the substrate and to form product. Okay, so this is the equation. Enzyme plus substrate gives enzyme substrate complex, and enzyme will convert the substrate to product. But inhibitor binds to the enzyme substrate complex in uncompetitive inhibition, and inhibitor will not allow the substrate to get converted into the product, okay, because it is inhibiting the enzyme substrate complex. Nothing will happen. This step will not happen. Okay, so the equation is V is equal to Vmax into substrate concentration by 1 plus I by Ki divided by Km divided by 1 plus I by Ki plus substrate concentration. What does this mean? Actually, you can call this as alpha also. If this is so big for you, you can call this alpha. This is nothing but it tells us about the inhibition rate, inhibitor and inhibited rate constant. Okay, so what happens in this? Vmax is decreasing here and Km is also decreasing here. Okay, since enzyme substrate complex is bound by the inhibitor, it is not allowing the rate, the reaction to occur. It is not allowing the reaction to occur. Rate of the reaction will not increase. So rate of the reaction here will be stagnant. Rate of the reaction will not go anywhere. Okay, if rate of the reaction does not go anywhere, then Vmax will be decreasing. If Vmax is decreasing, Km will also decrease. Okay, and how can you overcome this? You can overcome this by decreasing the substrate concentration. If there is more substrate, what will happen? All the substrate will bind to the enzyme substrate, and to this enzyme substrate inhibitor will bind. If the substrate concentration is less, there will be less enzyme which is occupied with the substrate, and quickly it will get converted to product before inhibitor goes and binds to the enzyme substrate complex, right? So that is a very good way to overcome this uncompetitive inhibition. So this is the graph of uncompetitive inhibition, where the lines will be parallel for you. Inhibitor and the enzyme lines will be parallel for you. Next is non-competitive inhibition. In non-competitive inhibition, what will happen? Inhibitor will bind to another location of the enzyme. You see here, inhibitor is binding. This is enzyme, this is substrate, this is inhibitor. Inhibitor is binding somewhere else. This is binding somewhere else. What happens is, when inhibitor is bound to the enzyme in another location, it is changing the conformation of the enzyme. Now, the enzyme is no more compatible to the substrate. Therefore, substrate cannot come and bind here. This causes rate of the reaction to decrease. Vmax will decrease, but Km will not be any change. Km will be unchanged here. That you can get it from the graph. So this is the graph. You see here, Vmax is changing, but Km is same. This is non-competitive inhibition. Okay. So the equation for this is V is equal to Vmax into substrate concentration by alpha divided by Km into alpha by alpha dash plus substrate concentration. Okay. All you have to remember is the plots. The plots you have to remember, how is the plots going with or without inhibitor and what is happening in Km and Vmax. That is all you have to remember. You don't have to remember anything else, for gate will not ask you more than this. Remember the graphs, like how they are going and what happens to Km and Vmax. That's enough, more than enough. So in competitive inhibition, you see Km is increased, Vmax is unaffected. Uncompetitive inhibition, Km is reduced, Vmax is also reduced. Non-competitive inhibition, Km is unaffected, Vmax is reduced. You can, if you want, you can take the screenshot of this plots and you can study them. This is important. Okay, in inhibition, this is what is important. And I have given you a table here, which is the simplified version of all the things we have studied now in inhibition. Okay. Competitive inhibition, uncompetitive inhibition and non-competitive inhibition and the values of Km, Vmax, 1 by Km and 1 by Vmax. Okay. You can actually take the screenshot of this image also, because this is the simplified one. If you can understand this and remember this, then you can solve the questions very easily. In competitive inhibition, Km increases, Vmax is same. So that will be opposite to 1 by Km. If Km increases, 1 by Km will decrease, 1 by Vmax will be same because Vmax is also same. In uncompetitive inhibition, Km is decreasing, Vmax is also decreasing. Km, 1 by Km will increase, 1 by Vmax will also increase. Non-competitive, you see, Km is same, Vmax is decreasing, 1 by Km is same and 1 by Vmax is increasing. They might sometime, I have actually added 1 by Km and 1 by Vmax because they might actually ask you this sometime. Okay, sometimes they can twist the question and not ask Km and Vmax and ask you 1 by Km and 1 by Vmax. You should be knowing that since they are inverse, they will be opposite. Okay, just know that is enough. If you do not want to by heart this, you will have to understand this. Because if you by heart stuff, it will not be there in your memory for a long period of time. You will forget it when you by heart. If you understand, it will be there in your memory for a long time. So, this is all about inhibitions and this is all about enzyme kinetics. It's a very important topic. You will get numericals from this area. So, understand them. Take time to understand them. Okay. I've already told you to make some short notes while you listen to the lecture. I hope you're doing that because that will be very helpful when you revise. So keep practicing, keep revising, keep studying and keep enjoying the process of learning, okay? So like, share and subscribe to our YouTube channel Gurmantra. You can join our Telegram channel Gurmantra, where you'll get constant updates about the classes, you'll get quizzes. You can join our Facebook page Gurmantra Siksha Ka Granth. You can visit our website www.gurmantra.in. For any further queries, you can mail us on TanejaNehaOfficial@gmail.com. You can contact us on 9351280000. Thank you so much. Have a nice day. Keep learning.